A very big announcement for the show this morning.
And the time is right about now to reveal exactly what it is. Mm-hmm. And Georgie, we should hear this from you.
Well, Lisa, I should probably start by saying I'm not pregnant.
Neither's Carl.
Neither's Carl. As far as I know, neither are you. Look, I wanted to announce to you today that I'm going to be finishing up on the Today Show. I promised I wouldn't get upset. I've given this a lot of consideration, obviously, but the time has come.
The front door is open, and so I grabbed this long stabby thing that I have next to the bed just in case someone breaks in.
A long stabby?
Yeah, because your bloke's got to protect his family, right?
Yeah.
So it got me thinking, what do you have by your bed that is long and stabby or whatever that is going to make a mess of someone who tries to break into your house and try and steal something from your home?
Well, Tim's my long stabby thing, but I used to have the Olympic torch under the bed when I was single, but yeah, now I've got Tim.
That's an excellent lucky long stabby thing. Yes.
Well, I just had a bite of Georgie's bun, and let me tell you. What?
Yes, Carl.
Just keep talking.
It's got a dirty
mind. I know.
And
just
I
keep
like
talking.
It.
Don't know where it comes from.
Anyway, I think it's got too many bits in it, Georgie.
Too many bits.
Yeah, like the too many raisins.
Yeah.
They're perfect.
I think they're outstanding buns.
Do is suck up to Georgie, Ben.
Yeah.
At some point, you've got to go
Carl,
hammer on Tom
News flash. Welcome to the program.
At some point, you've got to have a crack.
Look,
I would suggest you don't have a crack at my buns because they are very, very good buns.
What do you need that for anyway?
It's my bat phone.
Yeah.
Is it?
It's a hotline.
I love it.
See? Yeah. So what happens when you call that?
Oh, look, it's news time. Gosh.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, there you go.
Can I pick up that phone and see who's on the other end?
See, it's a magic phone. I think it only really has someone there when you're...
Executive producer bat phone. Hello? Hello?
They only answer to my voice.
It's just an affectation.
Exactly. They only answer to my voice.
Nothing actually happens.
I have been very well trained.
All right, Georgie. Thank you very much
well
for that.
Connected. You all right?
She is ready to go.
She's getting dressed.
She is.
The tallest man and the woman with the world's longest legs have launched this year's Guinness Book of Records in London. And that's the long and the short.
What about that? Stop looking at the Eiffel Tower. Don't you reckon? Unusual.
And a whole bunch of other things.
Yeah. Well, you could say that. I couldn't.
Whose idea was that shot?
It's put him between the legs. That's an odd story. We like random stories. You would have been up for a flirt,
what?
Georgie?
No, I wouldn't know how to flirt. I told you about the time I was direct. I told a guy I liked him, and he said, my parking meter's running out of money. Got to go. Didn't work.
Well, it worked out for you in the end, Georgie. Yeah.
Finally.
Yeah.
Finally. It was getting dusty up there on the shelf, got to tell you.
Yeah. Lucky that Tim and Toolman's a good cleaner.
He has technology. He spelt the end of the old-fashioned love letter.
Got a few of those in the drawer, Georgie?
Do you know, I'm sad to say I threw out a lot of my letters.
Did you?
I've always regretted it. Not that there were that many. Had a few. But yes, I'm not a hoarder.
No?
And I regret that.
Whereas
you are.
I keep way too much stuff. Way too much stuff. One day I'll pull it all out.
Please do and share.
I will.
That'd be good.
Good idea.
Maybe good TV.
No, not for that. Just a late night with you. Right now.
Now you're talking, Lisa.
Right now.
Forget the bromance, girlfriend. And the one that I just still cringe at when I think about it, I'd been into the country and my car was covered in mud, got home, tried to wash it with the sponges and hose it down, nothing would work. I got the pot scourer.
Oh.
I scoured my car.
Yes.
Took all the finish off. The whole lot. The whole lot, Ben.
How'd you go on your resale value
my
for
car.
That?
A new survey says more Australians crave chocolate over sex. 15% want to eat chocolate every day. I feel like I'm doing a late night talk show. As opposed to 8% who dream about action in the bedroom. What's so good about chocolate, Lisa? Talk to me.
Well, I'm struggling with the idea that chocolate and sex are mutually exclusive.
Lisa, why should we have to choose?
Mm. Mm.
They're not mutually exclusive.
Yeah.
Fabulous together.
Yes. Preferably melted.
And dark. With nuts.
You can melt your own, Carl. But it's shaved coconut.
It's true, desiccated coconut.
Desiccated,
just got to go to my dressing room.
Who's Danny Bonaducci?
Danny Bonaducci is
just a wog name.
He's the kid. He's the kid that played the little gorgeous ginger nut kid.
Oh, ginger nut.
That's said with enormous affection.
You can't say that.
Some of my best friends are redheads, including George's gorgeous husband.
Thank you very much,
ginger
Timbo.
Nut.
He doesn't mind being called ginger nuts. Don't you worry about that.
See, there you go.
Ginger nuts.
Maybe you just don't have any in your life.
It's just one. It's one nut, not two. Plural, Georgie. Kind of sexy, I guess.
Let's talk about nagging.
It's a good
Is
segue.
This the worst thing that a woman can do, Georgie?
Look, Carl, I'm not so het up about the smoking.
Yes.
But what about the mad bonkers who used to live above me in my block of apartments? Could you stop with the mad bonking in the middle of the night? That's what I will nag about. Trying to sleep. I remember getting the broom. Stop it! I left
that
a note.
What did the note say?
I was the nagger from hell to try and stop.
What actually did the note say?
Please, could you desist from your bonking in the middle of the night when I'm trying to sleep? Yes. So my biggest thing on the night was I didn't want to take my wedding dress off because I loved it so much.
Oh, you darling!
I loved my dress. But anyway, we got it off in the end.
You did or he did?
He did.
George, look, I'm blushing for you.
Move on.
What about the dress?
Oh, be quiet, Carl.
Finally, South Korea, I love this story, has introduced female-friendly parking spaces known as she-spots.
Okay. Here we go.
Georgie Gardner.
Oh, go, Georgie. I love it. I'm going to ask Channel 9 for a G-spot.
I don't know where we're going.
Georgie, that is brilliant.
That's
great, Georgie.
No, really good.
Do you reckon they'll be able to find you one?
Yeah. Probably not. The network's run by men.
And what's happening on the couch today? Something's really gone weird.
Unlikely to find it.
Because the man's in charge.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's life.
You can only find that park yourself, Georgie. It's been my experience.
Or with the help of...
something else.
How many hands have you got, Carl?
I don't know. I'm a bloke.
Just be careful, that whole ABBA thing. I think when Georgie and I turn around, we can do, you know? Ring, a lot of bamboo shoots.
Do you know, you are very clever. Georgie's able to tell if a panda is looking at ease.
I always think a panda looks like someone in a panda costume. And finally, one for the ages. A zoo in China has lost one of its rarest pandas. The one-year-old cub, who goes by the name of Wang Wang, managed to slip through a hole in his enclosure at Shanghai Animal Park. That was 2 days ago. Now, authorities believe the panda could be in Australia. They're using microchip and satellite technology to track the bear and say the latest signals suggest he might have reached Sydney. Experts are warning people not to approach Wang Wang. Despite their cuddly appearance, male pandas can be aggressive, especially during the mating season. What is going on?
What is going on?
It's a guy in a panda suit, goodness. Georgie. Like you've always suspected.
Oh, it is pandemonium. Wow. Finally.
Finally makes an appearance during one of your bulletins.
We've got panda tape.
We've even got panda tissues this morning. We've got it all covered.
We have three cheers for Georgie. Yeah.
Well done. We love you, Jerry.
We'll
see you all very soon on the Today Show.